Hi everyone! Today's tutorial is about how you can work with your mouse and keyboard in a principled way. The title sequence is waiting for you! As you might know, we have different kind of mouses. Some of them have lots of buttons, while others don't. When it comes to graphic designing, I prefer a simple one. Something like this one that is in front of you. If you press the left side of your mouse, we call it left click. Most of the times we use left click to select something. And when you press the right side of your mouse, we call it right click. If you right click on something, it will show you more options about it. What if we press and hold down the left click? We call it drag. Dragging usually helps us to move something to somewhere else. And in the middle, we have a scroll button. It can be seen much easier in the side view. If we look closer, it's nothing but a wheel. There are two ways that you can rotate it. Rotating it this way means scrolling up. We use a scroll up to zoom in and to see what's upper on a page. And if we rotate it this way, we call it a scroll down. We usually scroll down to see the lower part of a window and to zoom out. And if you press this wheel, we call it middle click. That's it for your mouse, and now we're gonna talk about using your mouse and keyboard simultaneously. On the keyboard, holding down Alt, Control or Shift, plus holding down middle click, right click or left click, most of the times helps you to move camera around the objects. The best way to use your mouse and keyboard is to always put your right hand on the mouse and your left hand on the keyboard. Never change this position unless you're gonna mess everything up. For your right hand, always put your index finger on the left click and put your middle finger on the right click. This way your index finger can cover the middle click as well. And for your left hand, always put pinky on shift, put the ring finger on A, put your middle finger on W, put your index finger on D, and put your thumb on a space. For the S, always use your middle finger, and this way your pinky can cover the control, your ring finger can cover caps lock, your index finger can cover Alt, X, and C, and if you move your hand forward, you can reach F, R, and T, and that way your ring finger can reach Q and Tab, and your thumb can also cover V and B. And of course it's not over. With a little bit more practice, you can reach more keys as well.
And now we've reached the end of this episode. Someone once said to create animation, work as a team. But if you have a team, the first person you should count on is yourself. Till the next episode, be strong and good luck.